In this session, I'll be discussing the 11th tip of the 19 powerful tips to create and manage or setting up the perfect project schedule or Gantt. Now, the 11th tip is that you need to avoid open-ended activities in a project schedule. Now, what is an open-ended activity? So first of all, it can be an activity with no successor activity, like task C. Task C doesn't have a successor activity. Or it can be an activity with no predecessor activity, like task G. Task G doesn't have a predecessor activity. Or it can be an activity like task H with no predecessor or successor linked to it. So what happens if we delay an open-ended activity? So let's have a look at task C. So if task C is delayed, it actually shows that there's no impact on another activity or even on your critical path, which is in actual fact incorrect. So why should we avoid open-ended activities? First of all, it brings into question the logic relationship within a project schedule. We don't know what is required to start an activity, if there's no predecessor activity, or what impact an activity has on a successor activity, if it's not linked to a successor activity. It can also create a false appearance of project float, as you might not know what is a correct float of an activity if it's not linked to a predecessor or successor. And then lastly, it can also damage the validity of your entire project schedule. So the only open-ended activity that you should be using in a project schedule is your start milestone. So that is our start milestone or our finish milestone. So that's the only open-ended activities that you should be using. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, or you can subscribe to my channel for more project management related videos. And you can also go to the description box below to watch the summary video of all 19 tips or the detailed video of each one of the tips.